Hi, I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. You watched list view, you watched grid view. Now we're going to get to the final and last view of the three, namely the path view. The path view is different from the list view and the grid view in that it will use almost 3D to present its data. Let's just look at an example of it right away. Here on my screen, we have the path view. It moves around on this path. Doesn't look much 3D-ish to you, I'm sure, but I can apply some certain effects, as we'll see very shortly, to these elements so that they have the appearance of being further away. Simply change a bit on their opacity, change a bit on their scale. But we'll see that in the next slide. The path view, as you can see set up over here, is pretty similar to the list view. We anchor, well, we've done that a million times. We set a model, we set a delegate, we set focus because it also supports the arrow keys, and then we set up a path. And setting up the path is pretty similar to setting up the path for our path animation. So let me just give you a URL here for the path animation video. So you can go back and watch that in case that you entirely forgot what that was about. Let's see this example here in action. It goes like this. So again, the example is exactly what you saw in the slides. You can move the items around here, and I can even just give them a good push and they will rotate around, and that's path view for you. The whole setup of this, pretty straightforward. We got the list model here. We've seen that a number of times. We get a component. The component is an image on top of a text. The image gets the file name for the image from model.file. That's what we have up here. It gets the text down here, gets model.name. That's what we have up there. If you watch the list view and the grid view videos, there's absolutely no surprise in that for you there. And now the path view. The path view is set up like this. So here's my path view again. And let me just show you the keys. Keys on left, that's the part that I couldn't show you in my slides, but you can see pressing the left mouse button, not mouse button, left arrow key here, I'm rotating this way, pressing the right, I'm rotating the other way. Anchor, fill parent, model, that's the model that I gave up here. Delegate, that's a delegate that we created here. Focus, that is so that my keyboard works. And finally, path, that is the path that I've created here. Again, please do go back and refer to the video on our path animation where I talk much more about this. But nevertheless, let me just draw this for you on the whiteboard so you can see exactly what each of these positions are. So our start X, start Y is at 150, 200. So 150 out, 200 down, that's approximately here. That is the point that is closest to you when you see the carousel of your items going around. The next point in our Bezier curve is at 50, 100. So 50, 100. If I can do a good drawing, that would be here. The following one is 150, 50. So 150. Oh yeah, of course. That's the topmost point that we have up here. And then following that, 250, 100. That also confused me, because I want this one to be online with this one over here. Now, this is our carousel that goes around. And obviously, it doesn't go rit, because this is done with Bezier curves. So it's more roundish and roundish and roundish. Let me see if I can do that. So roundish and roundish and roundish. Almost made it to that point and back down here again. Yes, I can do better. Let me just see. No, it didn't work. There we are. Now it worked. See, this beautiful image that you see on your screen now is not done by my abilities of drawing. It's done by QML. How did I do that? Well, I just went into the model or into my path view, and I changed the model not to be a model with these four images rotating around, but instead being a model of 100. If that confuses you, maybe you want to go back and see the video that we had on the model previous on. The other thing that I changed in there was the delegate. The delegate is just a rectangle now that is 5 by 5 pixels wide and is solid black. The four rectangles indicating the control points are purely just added as child elements to the path view. So here you can see exactly what is the path that we're traversing around. So that was the simple version of our path view. It didn't have that 3D effect I was promising you, so let's go back and look at the slides again here. The slides continue on saying, well, you can also specify attributes for each of the control points in our path view. And the way that that works is that when I set up my path, I also, besides setting the path cubic here, which is the control point that I can go to, I specify some additional properties, scale and opacity in this setup here of the slide. And then whenever my delegate needs to draw a given item, it can refer to the set order, the scale, and the opacity. We didn't see set order up here, but that's also in the actual example, simply by pathView.opacity, which is an attached property. We've seen that in previous video. So you can see up here where the application is actually running. These are scaled down a bit. This is scaled down even further. The opacity has also changed, which makes this one look dimmed out. And you can see if I rotate around here, you can see it looks really dimmed out there. And let's just see the whole thing in code, and we play a bit around with it. So again, my list model set up here, my components set up here. The component is slightly different because this time I change on my column, which is my topmost element, I change the opacity, the set, and the scale to be pathview.opacity, pathview.set, pathview.scale. And these are set up down here. So I start out, my current item is at 150, 100. My path attribute for that element is opacity, scale, and set value are these here. My next control point is at 50, 50. And again, opacity, scale, and set for that control point, and so on. The name opacity, scale, and set value is not something that is demanded by QML or PathView. That's simply names that I came up with. So I can change the opacity here to opacity X. And if I run it now, you will notice that they are all the same opacity because now it didn't find the opacity X anymore. I'm sure if I look at the output here that it complains about, well, that's behind my head. Jesper, can you go away? Thank you very much. So here you can see unable to assign undefined to double. That's simply because that it tried to read the opacity up here, opacity pathview.opacity, but no opacity was there anymore. So if we change that to opacity X, which was the new name I gave, you can see the opacity of these items have changed. You can do a lot of things with the path view. I'll bet you that there is the first 10 videos out on the internet or articles or just wiki pages that shows you how to set up a CD rotating. So you have the jukebox there where your CDs are rotating around back and then to the front again. And when they go back, they are smaller and so on. And they are all using this exact trick here. So for more inspiration, go and Google for jukebox and QML to see how other people have done it. That's the end of the path view. And we have one more video in this module here. We have seen the anchor layout. We saw seen the positioner when in the very beginning of this module here. So it's time for us to see the last layout manager that we have around in QML, because if you remember back to the video I talked about the anchor layout, I did this small survey inside of KDAB and asked people, which one are you using? Very few people were using the positioner. So I do not want you to end up thinking, hey, we have anchor layout and positioner. Positioner is good for repeater and it's good for examples like this. But in real life, you're going to use either the anchor layout or the Qt Quick layout elements. So let's end this module on the Qt Quick layout Until you see that video, have a great day.